Greetings to you, friends, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to today's devotional, which comes to us from the 19th Psalm. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day to day pours forth speech, and night to night it declares knowledge. There is no speech, nor are there words. Their voice is not heard, yet their voice goes out through all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. In the heavens he has set a tent for the sun, which comes out like a bridegroom from his wedding canopy, and like a strong man runs its course with joy. Its rising is from the end of the heavens, and its circuit to the end of them. And nothing is hid from its heat. The law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The decrees of the Lord are sure, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. And the ordinances of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, even much fine gold. Sweeter also than honey and drippings of the honeycomb. Moreover, by them is your servant warned. In keeping them there is great reward. But who can detect their errors? Clear me from my hidden faults. Keep back your servant also from the insolent. Do not let them have dominion over me. Then I shall be blameless and innocent of great transgression. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Clearly, this is a hymn of praise to God from David. And there seems to be two aspects of life that David is offering praise to God. One is, of course, from the beginning, it is in his creation, in his creative work, in his creative power, in the beauty and majesty of his creation. God's glory is revealed for all to see, for the entire world to see. And as David said, it comes without words. Creation itself does not speak literal words, but it speaks volumes to our Creator. The intricacy and the beauty of this world that he created can only come from a divine power and authority. It boggles my mind to think that there are people that believe that all of this started out of a pool or a pond somewhere and evolved into what it is now. The way the sun is the center of the solar system, the earth revolves around it, the moon, everything, the stars at night, is all of it is perfect, and it speaks of God's glory, and certainly he is worthy to be praised for that, but also that we stand in awe, or as they say in the Old Testament, have the fear of the Lord, for his authority and power is immense and beyond what we can possibly understand. And then David goes on to give thanks to God for the law that was given to the people of Israel as a blessing and as a gift, not ever meant to be a burden, even though obedience to it can be very difficult and challenging and sometimes burdensome. There is still grace and forgiveness of God. It is not something that he smites us when we fail to follow his laws. And because of his power and majesty and sovereign creative power, the gift that we've been given in creation, the gift of the law, or in our case in the New Testament, obedience to God, seems normal. It seems like the thing we should expect to do is to follow and trust in a God who has revealed himself so powerfully in creation. And though we don't have a law ourselves, we have a law of love, a law of justice, and the law that Christ gave us is love God and love our neighbors. Following that isn't always easy, but it's the best way we can live our lives, and it's what's best for all of us if we lived our lives that way. And David finishes this psalm with a prayer, more or less. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you. And that's something we should all strive for because of the gifts we have from God, not just in creation, but salvation and eternal life and the peace of his presence and the joy and all the things that I've spoken about in these devotions and all the things that you've heard and read in scriptures that we have from God, that we should have lives, live lives that are pleasing to him. The words that come from our mouths and the things that come from our heart, the actions that we do, we should strive to please God in that as a reflection of the glory of his creation and us being the pinnacle of that. It should be something we strive for. So how will you, or how have you magnified God today? How have you lived your life in a way that reflects his grace and his love and his glory as the best way to live our lives, as the best plan for humankind, for us to thrive? Selfish lives and self-centered lives benefit no one, not even ourselves. And though that can be a challenge in our consumerism world, it is truly a gift of from God that we are given the privilege to represent him in this world. So strive each day, today and every day, to be the best version of yourself and to give God glory through your words, through your actions, through your thoughts, through the way that you spend your time and all the other resources that God has given us. I offer this prayer. Thank you, Lord, for revealing yourself to us so powerfully in your creation. Thank you for the guidance that we receive from your Holy Spirit that tells us and reveals to us the truth about you and who we are because of you, and also a guiding light for us in this world to best reflect and witness to the power of your grace and mercy. Help us to do that as best as we can each and every day, and strive to do better each and every day. Thank and praise you in Jesus' name. Well, friends, we'll see you tomorrow for Psalm 20. Have a good day.